Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Shekhar Usta Arif, and on behalf of AIKTC School of Architecture, I welcome you all to the Kulki Symposium 3 of academic year 2021 and 22. As we all know, AIKTC SOA has been hosting Kulki, a series of seminars designed for students to gain deeper understanding of this field from professionals who are invited to share their expertise and insights with us. So today, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome and introduce our guest, Amrita Daulatabadkar, ma'am. I welcome you, ma'am, to this platform. A little details about her. She is the founder of the firm Amrita Daulatabadkar Architects, which was established in the year 2013, with which she talks about her take on good design, architecture, and clients. She believes in creating concept-driven, contextual work, something that would be complete in itself, and did not need to resort to cosmetic treatment. She has bagged several awards, such as the Young Emerging Interior Architect Award 2017, 20 JK Architect of the Year Award for Private Residence, IID Anchor National Award 2017, winner of Young Practice of the Year, and NDTV Interior Award for Hospitality 2017, and top three nominations for Amoyed Idea Next 2018 Gold Winner for Residential Villa, and lastly, winner of Wade Asia 2018. Her projects have been featured in various publications. Inside Outside October 2016 for Residential Single Dwelling, IIA Order Bulletin August 2016 for Residential Single Dwelling, Better Interiors June 2000, Coit Idea Next New Delhi Edition 2018 as
today, I'm going to present few of my projects where I can actually explain these spaces. As I and Suvidha discussed, like it will be more beneficial for all these students if I talk more about spaces. So I'll be very happy to explain how our firm designs, what is the procedure and how these spaces come up. And first of all, thank you that I've been invited on this platform. I'm really glad to be the part of the webinar. Thank you. Thanks a lot, respected principal, head of the department, and Suvidha for initiating this. I hope the students really get benefited with this. Let's start with my presentation. Now, this is the first slide where I will like to show like how directly, indirectly, we get influenced by our travel or by our surrounding, by our nature. And this I will explain you in my later slides, how these photos are related. So in the first photo, you see a stepwell. In the second photo, you see a small courtyard pic, which is a heritage wada. So how the interactive spaces come up from a courtyard. The third pick is of nature. So how colors influence us in our design and how we subconsciously incorporate those colors because somewhere we have seen it. Travel is important and by keeping our vision totally open and keeping our vision broad is very important. Why our history is important, why our heritage is important. I'll start with my first project, which is inward-looking courtyard house. Very glad to say this was my first architectural project, so will always remain very close to my heart, our office. This project is very special because the context is very challenging. For us, it was very challenging context. As the house was having only one side road and all the three sides with the adjacent building. So we had no scope of taking light and ventilation or allowing any fenestration from all the three sides. So the challenge was how to ventilate all the rooms, how to ventilate toilets, give light, natural ventilation to all the parts of the bungalow. The plot area was just 1080 square feet. So to carve out these spaces was a challenge because the requirement was as a bungalow, normal bungalow, like 3 BHK study area, a small courtyard carved in, dining space, living areas. So on the first, basic planning was on a staggered level. So we have a staggered level planning, as you can see in the section here. So it's a courtyard, through a section through a courtyard, and the levels are interconnected by a staggered planning. So this gave not only privacy to the bungalow, but also we could occupy maximum number of space in a small 1,080 square feet plot area. You can see this is the car parking porch carved out, and then you enter the living space. We have a kitchen. Courtyard becomes a dining space as well as a source for light and ventilation. Then you step down and you have a study area and a powder room. On next level, the benefit of what we could gain from the staggered level was actually the passage area was avoided. So as soon as you step to the staggered level, the first mid-landing level, you can directly enter to the bedroom space. So the passage area was reduced, and that passage area we could actually utilize in other utility spaces for the bungalow. So on the next level, we have incorporated two bedrooms. Now in the bedroom, which is on the front side, which is north, has the window opening from the northwest side. So the privacy of the bedroom is not disturbed, as well as the ventilation has been taken from west side. And for the bedroom, which is inside the access from the mid landing, has a light source from the courtyard. And you can see here how the corner terrace has been carved out, where the toilet gets natural light and ventilation for both the bedrooms attached toilet. On the next floor, there is a third bedroom again from the second mid landing. Then you again climb up to the second floor level, and you have a terrace. Again, the terrace has a double height, so the toilet attached to this has natural ventilation from the terrace cut out. So this is how the natural ventilation to the toilets and bedrooms have been worked out. So this is the section. This section is from the staircase. So a louvered part of the facade, which has been given to the staircase, gives ventilation to the staircase also. This is the northwest side window. So because of that, you can get the ventilation to the bedroom and the toilets, direct ventilation from the terrace. This is the courtyard view. So how light plays its role and how we have ventilated all bedrooms, kitchen, dining space. This is the corner view. Now see here, you see the same courtyard pic, which is an influence of a heritage structure. Now, the interesting part of this about this heritage structure is it was a neighboring wada of my own house, of my own residence, which I used to see from my childhood, which was the part of my neighbor's house. So I must have never thought of implementing this in my future projects, or I must have never thought of taking architecture also. But I want to relate it to how these influences, which we see, which we observe, play a lot of important part in our design process. So this is how your vision, your travel, your observation helps you out. These are a few more courtyard pics, how the connectivity takes place. The topmost bedroom is 1.5 time height of the normal bedroom or the normal floor level. This helps us into the gravitational force, which we utilize for water supply to these toilet areas. So we did not need to create any fabricated stands for the water supply and gravity. Indirectly, the floor height helped us to get the force for the water supply on the topmost bedroom part. And it created into volume also. So you can see a double height staircase coming up, and that created some interesting break in the total volume of the space. Now see, this is the toilet picture of the same bungalow. I was traveling to Sri Lanka, and there somewhere in Jofri Bawa structure, I noticed this courtyard with the stone louvers. You know, when you travel, you just click pictures, you just observe. You know how it influences in your project also. So while we were designing, and when we thought that our material palette is going to be very, very subtle, like Kadapa and Shahabad, why the material palette, actually I wanted to come on that point on the later section for the material palette. the material palette for this house is very humble. But in spite of keeping it humble, we have used it in a different way. In some toilets, the kadapa has been cut into 1-inch strips, and then we have designed the flooring in 1-inch strip of kadapa. Somewhere it is old slabs, somewhere shabad has been cut in various grids. Shabad and kadapa lures or the pergola have been formed in the toilet. See how it influences our design. That's why travel is so important in our life, in our career. So that doesn't mean you have to only travel abroad. Your neighboring house also helps you if your vision is wide enough and observation is there. I'll switch to second project, which is a green belt done for one of our builder clients. So there is a system of taking a responsibility of green belt or green zones for 5 years from government, and then you can maintain that green belt. So our client had a space near their apartment area, which they took from the government, and now they're maintaining that green belt for 5 years of span. So area just 1200 square feet. Again, there is a historical reference how we have designed that green belt. I belong to Aurangabad city, as you must all be aware of, and Aurangabad is full-fledged influence with different types of cultural heritage and history. So we have Mughal, we have Hindu, we have Jainism, so we have Buddhism, so all kind of heritage and history. So we are blessed with that. And we have history of Malik Ambar, who is considered to be the architect of the Aurangabad city, because he was the one who designed fetching in water and supplying water to the city by collecting it from the mountains. Aurangabad is based between the mountains. So he designed the air shafts and the air ducts, the aqueducts, which we still find in the city area. And there are Nehre Ambris in the city flowing. So the water was collected, and through the water levels, maintaining the levels, he supplied the water and collected in the Harsul Lake. And then the water was supplied to the whole city. So this was the heritage and history. So it's been influenced from that. So what we have done here is, we got this chunk of land, which was 1200 square feet, located between the service road and the highway. So what we did was, we collected the highway water, which is rainwater, will be collected in the gravels besides the footpath. So you can find the gravel part. This is a footpath, the highway. And then that water will be collected on the platform which we created. And that will through drains, through brick jalis, and will be collected in a stepwell. And there below the stepwell, we have done a rainwater harvesting pit. So that was our concept, how to collect the water through the drain jalis of made up of brick. So brick was again the material palette. Brick has a capacity of soaking in water. So we kept it very humble and simple so that maximum amount of water can be collected and soaked in. And gravels, as you know, that water gets filtered through gravels, and dust remains and the dirt remains on the upper part, and the filtered water gets into the... Now here are the sections, how the brick jali drains were carved out. So you can see how the water gets collected from the main road at detail YY. So screen must be visible. So from main road at detail YY, we collect the rainwater, and the water flows through the channel. And through the channel, through the levels created on the brick part, on our landscape part, the water gets supplied from top floor platform to the other levels, and to the through the brick channels into the stepwell. Now, this is one part which we practice in our office, which is model making. So, of course, there must be the same thing going on in your college also, because that is the base of our design. Now, what we did was, it was a very simple project. So, we just made paper models. These are all paper folds. So, it must be very visible. This is the shadow there. So, these are simple paper fold models which we have done. And the proportions were designed, the freestanding walls proportion were designed on the paper foil models. And the project was executed. So this we have a practice. Either we make paper foil models, either we make thermocol models, cardboard models. We finalize the proportions on them and then we execute it. We retain 3Ds in our office. Extremely sorry for this disturbance. I'm not keeping well from few days. So this is how water gets collected. And this project has also been used as a connecting space through the steps provided from the surface road to the highway. Quickly running through the, now see how from the upper levels, the water gets drained into the below road level drains. And to the step well. So in the right hand side, you can see the highway part, which is on the upper level. Left hand side is the service road and the steps connected. This is how it works. Okay, next project is Ramai Boys Hostel, which we recently even uploaded on our social platforms. Project span was almost three and a half years. The basic idea to create spaces in the hostel was more of inward looking because the atmosphere, the neighboring atmosphere was not that interesting. And definitely youngsters want something which is happening atmosphere around them. So our basic concept was, why not create something which is inward looking atmosphere? And hostel planning was kept very simple, very simple. Same floor plates on all floors, but the walls were shuffled so that every room created was differently done, different interiors. All the 16 room has different interiors in the hostel. Now in this on the slide, you can see stage 1, stage 2, stage 3 and stage 4. So in stage 1, it's a simple floor plate. We have around these trees. There's one tree which is inside the building, which has not been chopped off. The same tree has been used as a sitting space and it is also in the bedroom space. Stage 2 is coming out the courtyard. Stage 3 is coming out a courtyard and then a staircase. And stage 4 is a terrace, a courtyard and a staircase. So keeping it on very simple X and Y axis, we have the hostel. So this is how it looks from outside. We have not chopped any of the tree. So our tree is our base. Tree is our soul building. Because usually what we do is, how our building is going to look, the way we plan the fenestrations, the way we design the windows. Here we have gone with the reverse process. We have made our planning. The windows of the hostel is as per the tree location. So every window you open up, you see a tree. So our windows are flexible as per the location of the trees. It's nothing as per the elevation. So that was our basic. So this is the ground floor. We have still floor plan. So we have all services. There is a proposed gym part and mess part and rector's room. On the upper floor, we start with this. So when we enter into the courtyard. So staircase from the ground to first takes you to the courtyard, and the upper floor staircase is different. So on the west side is the upper floor staircase. So here you see all the rooms are differently planned. The layout of the rooms are different. From room number one, where you can see a tree coming up in the room. Room number two, room number three, four, five, six. Every room has different layout. So that creates interesting part in the hostel itself, that people have some topic to talk amongst themselves, interact amongst themselves. In this, you can see that there is only one lobby space which connects the staircase and the whole hostel area. So the passage area was reduced and it connects the courtyard also. And the lobby space is kept wide enough, 8 feet wide, so we can create inbuilt spaces in the lobby, which give the interactive atmosphere in the hostel. So even a courtyard is a sitting space. On the top floor, you see the lobby space, which is B, overlooking the courtyard, the inbuilt sitting spaces in the lobby, And on the top floor, again, you have a terrace, which is H, a courtyard, and G is a semi-covered terrace. So it's an interactive amphitheater kind of terrace. You will see in the photographs. This is a section through the courtyard. So courtyard is south facing. So it was again a challenge to how to cut down the south glare as well as give ventilation to the building. So we choose to have a courtyard with a jali. So it gives natural ventilation to the courtyard as well as to the whole building. We have created windows between the rooms. So you can just have an interesting feeling, like if there is birthday of someone and you don't want to knock on the door and you want to give surprise to your friend, you can just jump from the window and surprise your friend. So we had an old concept of connecting houses in the old culture. So that same thing we have used here. So why not connect through windows? Why not connect each other through windows? Why every time privacy plays the role? When you want privacy, just shut the windows. When you want to interact, open up the windows. So we have different windows. We have louvered windows. We have huge windows. We have pivoted windows where you just want to lend a charger to your friend and you can just knock rather than opening a door. This is how tree comes in the building. This is a view through courtyard, how the jharokas come in the courtyard and then spaces get connected. So courtyard and lobby space becomes an interactive space. This is the terrace part, semi-covered terrace part. So X axis connects you through and through to the rooms, location of the rooms around courtyard. So what we have done is we hired an artist and asked him to create an illusion paintings on the walls so that dead walls don't seem to be dead. They seem to be connected. So you can see how a circular staircase has been painted. And it seems like that you still have an access. So you don't see a dead wall. So how the inbuilt spaces have been created. The rooms, the wall art in the rooms, the lobby space. Courtyard view from the lobby. So these are the room interiors. Again, the material palette has been kept very simple. So we have customized the study tables by Kadapa platforms. The light design has been converted into the study ledges. See the another room which has totally different interiors. So study table is behind the bed area, and how the window is the connecting space to the others and the jharokas. The next project I'm going to show you is Amigo's Kitchen, which is totally interior project. Now, this is an hospitality small restaurant project. Here the material palette, the play of material was very important. So from first project I'm saying ki in a courtyard house we have used simple, very humble material, Kadapa and Shahabad, because of the context, as the house was built in a very humble area, so we did not want to client feel disconnected through their surroundings, but used in a different way. The second project was the landscape project where we have used brick so that brick and gravel so that water can get percolated easily. The third was hostel. Again, this palette was very simple, but the interiors, the play of material and the interiors of the rooms were differently done. Now, the fourth is Amigo's Kitchen, where the material, you see there is brick, exposed brickwork and MS plate. So that is the basic of So in the roof, you can see how we have designed the roof, which is done in an MS plate, the brick and the textured walls. Now Spaces, again, it's a very small restaurant, 1100 square foot restaurant. But when you enter the parking space of the restaurant, you see through and through. So a very simple planning, the outdoor sitting, the indoor sitting, the planning has been done in a very linear way. So you don't see anything staggered coming up here. And the vision from the entrance cash counter area. So maximum you see, you feel the restaurant has a larger space. So the concept was showing a small space into a larger area. So once you stand outside and you see through and through till inside, you feel a restaurant has a huge sitting space. So that was the concept. So how the spaces are to be designed as per the context, as per the requirement. So this is how the linear connectivity comes up. So these are the brick walls. So these become the highlighting part. So this red indicates how the highlighting walls come up. So front is the elevation, then the brick walls, then the through and through glass, you see the brick wall of the internal restaurant part, the cash counter, and behind the cash counter. So visual experience is from outside to inside. Now this is a graphical representation where you see the material has been played in a very unique way of bringing in dynamics. So though it's a stable structure, but by tilting it, by playing with the form of diamond shape, roof, or the tilted bricks or the tilted flooring, you find some dynamics in the structure. So a small restaurant with keeping only two material palette, which is brick and MS. So whole dynamic has been brought by the designing of the material, how you design it. So this is how roof has been designed. Section shows how the parking, outdoor space, the indoor space are connected. This is a step down sitting, the outdoor sitting space, the indoor part. So indoor and outdoor roof is connected. The cash counter part. So you see the cash counter from the entrance itself. How the small spaces or the play of material plays an important role in creating interest in the small space itself. This is my last project, which is a renovation project. Here, we didn't have much scope to play in concept wise. The basic concept was how you can create through colors. So in the first slide, I showed you some pictures of the nature, how the green, the pink flowers, and how you can connect it through your interiors and your nature. So a simple plan. It was an open concept plan, a renovation project. See how you connect. So you have walls, you have brown curtains, and you have pink sofa, and you can relate it to the nature. So this doesn't come. Now, you cannot just go randomly through your travel photographs and pick the colors. No, it doesn't happen that way. It is there in your brain because you have seen it somewhere. And when you start designing, you automatically, your subconscious mind automatically inspires you and automatically makes you select those colors. And then you realize, oh, this is already there in our nature. This is already what we have visited. We have seen. A very open concept house.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So hello, I am Namira, and first of all, I would like to thank you, ma'am, for sharing your precious knowledge and practical experiences with all of us. I personally Like how you highlighted the fact that inspiration could come from anywhere, especially travel and simple observation in your surrounding and stories, and the inspiration you got from the heritage and history and relating it with architecture and highlighting it, and the way we should look at our site and the importance of material palette and how we could incorporate it in our spaces. So it was a really an enlightening and insightful presentation. Thank you for all your efforts, ma'am.
I want to bring into notice, there's nothing cheap, there is nothing cheap material, there is nothing called costly material, or there is nothing called good or bad material. It's all about the way you use it. So it's nothing key. If you use simple brick or down to earth very humble material, your building can't look nice. Or there's no thumb rule also that you don't have to use costly material. You can use anything. There is no boundaries. There is no limitation. How you handle is important. That is the most important part. So the way you handle, the way you bring, and the way you incorporate in your design is important. So there is only one thing, good and bad. So good design and bad design. Otherwise, there's no limitation. You cannot judge anyone's design. For somebody, my design can be bad. Not up to mark. For someone it can be good, for someone it can be very good. So it's nothing about judging someone's work, it's about how you incorporate things, it's about how you put them to your design. So I feel students should understand that from basics itself, like spaces are very important. If your plan is good, you don't need to take any efforts in your elevations. So your plan itself becomes your elevation part. You don't have to take efforts. If your choice of material goes with your design theme, your concept, your interior is automatically coming up well. So extra efforts, extra lipstick treatment is not much projects where you have thought it from the base itself. So that should be done from your design day one process itself. Your base should be very strong. So there's nothing called concept. It's all about base, putting in soul. It's about context. It's about the user. There's no need of walkthrough, making a walkthrough for your presentation. It's all about how you imagine yourself in that building. So your own brain should be your walkthrough. You should be able to make a walkthrough while you're designing. There's no need of 3Ds. So that is how you should train your brain. You can imagine yourself in that space and imagine how you want. And make it beautiful.
Yes, ma'am. Very truly said. So now we'll take the questions from our audience. So you guys put your questions in the chat box, or you guys can raise your hand for the question.
Please make it very informal. Be very frank. Ma'am, I love to interact with all of you. Don't hesitate. Just make it friendly. Ma'am. I don't think so. I'm that
ma'am,
old
I,
enough.
I would like to ask.
Yeah, go on.
Yes, ma'am. So, how do you convince your client for the ideas you have in your mind, and they might also have some ideas and suggestion for their structure. So how you try to convince them, and how you incorporate their responses?
Yeah. So first of all, you yourself should be convinced. You yourself should be confident enough to present yourself. When a person sees confident on your face, when a person sees something right in your eyes, I don't think so there's need of taking extra effort to convince anyone. See, nobody can 100%. There is always 50% chances or 70-30% chances. 70% convincing your client is an achievement. So if you are honest, and if somebody sees that on your face, it's already done. So first thing is, be honest. Second is, you yourself should be convinced. It's not only about presenting. You should be honest with yourself, and you should be confident about what you're doing. So already your part is done. And rest follows. So there's no special efforts to be taken to convince anyone. if you do something right, the same type of people will get attached to you. So do something right and the right will come back to you. Don't try to portray what you're not.
Yes,
be very transparent in your design, in your work. And that is how the same company will get attached. So your confidence is your capacity.
We have another question. Can you please throw some light on the scope and ideas of incorporating landscape and interior?
Landscape and interiors. Honestly, I did not understand this question. Landscape and interiors is what? Like interior spaces? It's what exactly? Dry landscape? Or what exactly was the point? I'm not able to hear you.
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
No, I'm not able. Is somebody asking me a question?
No, mad box.
Okay. So landscape and interiors, I honestly don't understand the question, but what is landscape actually? See, we treat that subject as very different subject, but it's actually not that way. The day one, when you start designing your building, the day one, when you start designing your layout, the landscape comes in the day scope itself. So automatically the spaces has to be created. It cannot be attached later on. So there is no anything to put in light or put in ideas differently. It has to be incorporated from day one. So if you are sitting in your room and if you have a balcony space, so how are you going to imagine your balcony space to be? You want some potted plants, you want some inbuilt plants, you want some one highlighting plant. So start your layout itself with that. And that is how you start incorporating. So that is how land comes in your interior space.
I guess Shakib Khan has a question. He had raised his hand. Shakib, you can go ahead with your question.
Hello, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yeah, hi. Yes, you are.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Actually, my question was to you is that how far can we reach through using this type of structure? Is it possible to construct a high-rise building or a skyscraper through this?
Through what?
Using such vernacular type of structures, using bricks and all such materials. Is to construct a high-rise building or a skyscrapers as well?
Skyscraper. I really doubt. You have to ask to a structural designer for that. But when the terms skyscraper comes in, so it's all about technical things coming in. Like you have to calculate the wind load, the wind speed, the impact of wind, the weather conditions, everything comes in. So when these conditions come in, you have different people in your team. You have a structural designer, you have a facade designer, there's an architect coming inside. So maybe at that time, how your structure reacts to the atmosphere, to the wind load and the wind pressure or the atmospheric condition, depends on that. Why not? If you are designing a very sound building with a brick, with load carrying capacity, the facade can, so definitely you can use that material palette also.
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, we have another question. How does people respond to the exposed material palette?
Yeah, now that's a very good question, because when it comes to a layman, who is not in from architectural background, wo plaster baki hai building ko, sir nahi complete hua, building incomplete hai. So I feel, shit man, what is this? So I just have to smile. Yes, plaster baki hai. So a layman comes with that question and I have to answer like a layman to explain them. But when people from our background come down, so they appreciate it. Few people feel it's not appreciated. So people react differently. So at the end of the day, it's all about how you feel about your own building. And yes, if there are some negative comments, if there are some improvement, definitely one should take it positively. So you can improve structure in your next building. So sometimes it's welcoming, sometimes it is criticizing. So it's both way.
Like once the structure is done, how the client responds to like the exposed materials? It's a bubble, basically.
Fortunately, my client was very happy. My client did not say the building looks incomplete. So he was very happy in that sense. So he was very happy that I saved his color. I saved his plaster amount also. So that way also he was very happy. He was just concerned about leakages and we sorted out. So when leakages was not a problem, so he reacted well. So it depends from client to client. If you do not like the rustic interiors, they want totally chic interiors and we are okay with that. Or totally chic look. We are totally okay with that. So in that sense, what we do is we feel okay, fine, no problem. Let's go for something chic and you can create something in that chic part also. There's nothing right, wrong. It's all about good and bad.
Yes, ma'am.
With the challenges.
We have another question. When in incorporating idea from heritage, what's your opinion on how much originality does the design should have?
Okay, so you mean to say if we take any inspiration or if we take any ideas heritage, that doesn't have an originality to the building. So you give an attached toilet to your bedroom space. So does your bedroom lose the originality of the design? So designing a attached toilet is a copying? No, I don't think so. It's an idea, it's a derivation, which already back then has been happened. So giving an attached toilet or giving a public toilet in a public building is not losing an originality. It's following some basic concepts, which already has been derived long back by functionality, by atmospheric condition, by context. And if you are using something from that, by your own way, not by copying the same way, how an originality will be lost? I don't think so. It is in fact that you are using something what your ancestors or heritage has been given to you and you have been gifted in your own way. So you are somewhere continuing your original.
How are the services and the electric wiring taken care of the exposed in the exposed material palette?
In that case, we kept all exposed. So all the you must have seen the interior parts. All the piping has been done through MS pipes, and those same as I explained, the same electrical design has been converted into the wooden ledges for the shelves, the wooden shelves and the ledges for the study areas. So everything has been kept exposed. So we have taken extra efforts to design it. Now here, aisa hai na ki khud problem karo aur usko solve karo. So abhi expose kiya na, so design the electrical part also. Nothing is hidden. So you have to take extra efforts to design the electrical part also. So it has to look better. And that has its own essence and that has its own beauty.
Yeah, very true. So like the next question, do you have a signature language in your project or to adapt as per your whatever project
there's no signature language. Whenever project, I go totally blank. What to do? I have no idea. So, and I'm so underconfident, to be very honest. So, it's like fear. जैसे वो design project देते हैं, thesis होता है ना, same वैसे fear आज भी हमको feel होता है. So, we are afraid. Oh, now we have got this project. Now, how to do it different than earlier? And the same idea should not be copied. The same planning should not be copied. So, the fear starts from there, and then we. And then slowly when you enter into the design process, it comes up. So you have to adapt. You have to adapt as per the client, as per the context, as per his lifestyle, as per his demands. So there's no signature language.
Yes, ma'am. So anybody who wants to ask question can like mute yourself and go ahead with their questions.
Come on, ask a few more questions.
Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Like how to convince ma'am, like towards this vernacular type of structures, like in nowadays we think now like in people's mind it is created like we want like contemporary architecture, and but we know that as compared to contemporary it is like cheap, not we can say that it's cheap, but low maintenance and all. So how can we convince like the society
all,
towards,
let me correct you, vernacular is not at all low maintenance. So we have experienced it, so it's not low maintenance at all.
Okay.
And second thing, as I said initially, that you don't need to convince. First, you need to be confident about yourself. Second, you need to psychologically study your client requirement also. Somebody who is interested in putting an Italian marble, you can't force that person to put Shaban. No, not at all. Not at all. You cannot go extreme. That depends totally on the lifestyle. If somebody is ready to do wooden ceiling, you can't force him to make gypsum ceiling. So first, you have to be doctor, a psychological doctor to your client, psychologist to your client. Try to understand your client. And this is a very important part. See, forcing something is designing. Adapting, as somebody asked, do you adapt as per your projects? Yes, adapting is something designing. So if you always keep on forcing what you feel is right on others, then it's not being very versatile. It's not very open-minded. It's being stubborn. And if one is stubborn, then how can one be a designer? So you have to be very open. If client is allowing you to use an Italian marble, you can be sensible enough to explain him the plus and minus of the Italian marble and use it sensibly. So, and client is ready to take your experiments by using the vernacular material, the locally available material. So design it accordingly so that client doesn't feel that he is using some old standard materials and then how is going up. We had a question in courtyard house that using same Kadapa Shabad, this is not upgradation. So why are we making new house? So what we did was we designed the old material. The grid was different. The type of design was different. The groove designs were different. And then they start feeling, okay, the simple and vernacular also looked good. So this is how your role play comes in. So how you can convince them by keeping their originality or keeping the material's originality and vernacular part is by designing them, not blankly using them. So you don't need to convince. So there are cost factors, there are context factors, there are designing factors, there are sustainability factors, there are different factors. And when you study all these factors with client psychology, I guess the convincing part goes away. It happens automatically.
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, you just said that.
Yes,
understand client psychology. How can we understand a client psychology? I mean, what question or what deductions you do?
Okay, so you must be knowing Ambani's and you must be on Tata's, right? Are you aware of both of them?
Yes, yes, yes.
So do you find any difference in both of them?
They are businessmen.
But do you find any difference in both of them? Business is their basics. But do you feel Tata is different from Ambani?
Yes.
Okay, Ambani. So I don't want to go into the differences. Do you find any difference?
No, I don't.
You don't find any difference between Tata's working style and Ambani's working style?
Tata's are more classic. Ambani's is like whatever the...
Okay, now I will definitely give you some homework. Just go and study the business strategy and you study business ways. See, I'm not talking about good and bad. It's about the difference. So these both personalities stand differently yet do the same thing. So I don't know any of them personally. I've never met any of them. I've just read about them. I've seen their outcomes. I've seen their business strategies. I've read about their business strategies. I've read about their business. So how you study them? We study them through their strategies. So in spite of not meeting them, we know the basic difference between both of them. They both work in the same field, the same business, but differently. So that is how you study human psychology. You may see my work, you may find me different. You may see somebody else's work, you may find it good and different. So how? Both are good, both are bad, but both are different. So how you study by observation. So this is how interaction comes in. This is how observation comes in. When you talk to someone, see, you must be having 50 students in a class. All 50 cannot be your best friend, right?
Yes.
You must be having a couple of them who are close to you, if I'm not wrong, or maybe four of them. You have a group together. So how did you differentiate it? By getting or involving with their talks and by interacting with them, right?
Yes.
So this is how you differentiated. That's why your psychology and their psychology matched, right? The frequency matched. And this is the way you study your clients also. When you meet them, you start studying them. The day one, first meeting itself is how you understand the client is. Their requirements itself shows you their psychology. The type of house, contemporary, modern, vernacular, starts opening up about their psychology. And that is how you start studying them. Once they open up, you start learning them.
Got it.
Last question for the day. How does the shift of material works? For example, in the boys' hostel where the structure is in brick and in the courtyard, there is a steel balcony. What is your take on visual break blocks that material create?
Yeah. Now, very interesting question. There was a quite monotony created in the whole structure because of the exposed brick part or the finished off walls we have done. So we started wondering ourselves how to bring in color. So what is the part which can break the monotony? So in the basic design, we see there is some set point, attraction point. You have very basic design exercises. There is some point which is highlighted, or there is something which is merging. So whole of our brick structure was merging. But then how to make something which creates an interest? And that gives a breakthrough material. So that comes up ki how you can make a composite structure yet blend it together. And to break the monotony, the composition of the structure, the composite structure, which steel structure came in the brick exposed brick part, we colored them. So that is how it's a process. It's a process. When you see, when you go on sites, when you see and imagine yourself on the site, you find that, oh, there is a kind of monotony created, and how to break that monotony. So it comes through color. So your material itself breaks that monotony.
Yes, ma'am. I'm very well said about it. So I would like to give the final vote of thanks on behalf of AIKTC here together, extending a very heart vote of thanks to all. Thank you, ma'am, for connecting with us and sharing your precious knowledge with us. And I would also like to thank our director, sir, our dean, sir, and faculty members for their coordination. And this event wouldn't have been possible without the students and organizing team. Thank you so much, guys, for the energy. And finally, all our audience, thank you so much for paying your kind attention. And I hope you guys have gained the valuable knowledge from this symposium and whatever ma'am like had shared with the knowledge. So now I would like to officially end the event. And thank you so much to all. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much for making me part of this and inviting me. I'm really glad, and I really hope that students are not bored and they found something interesting in my presentation, and if I can really help them in their process and time, I'll be really happy to know that from Suvidha. I hope Suvidha,
yes,
things were good.
Hi. Yeah, it was really good, Amrita, and what I was expecting. Thank you for joining with us, and I also wish that student have gained a lot of knowledge, and it might create some ambition or something like that. I feel that. So made the lot some students can also join Amrut later on if they are interested to yeah. So and thank you so much, Amrita.
I was not well, and maybe I was not sounding very good and enthusiastic. So please excuse me for that.
No, ma'am, everything well, perfectly, and the presentation was really good.
Thank you so much, and keep going good.
We wish to see more work from you, Amrita, for future also.
Hopefully, God helps us in doing more and more good work, and we be a part of your college always. So interact students. So always make it very informal. So it gives very nice feeling to talk to students. Don't make it formal. So I'll be always so, glad to be part. And if I can inspire your students someday, it's great for me.
It's really nice from your side. And we will definitely try to do that. That we will
thank
make
so
one team.
Thank you to Honorable Principal and Head of Department also to allow you to invite me. I'm really thankful to them.
Thank you.
Okay. Bye, all of you. Have a nice day and work hard. Architecture is very interesting. We are very blessed that you all are in architecture. So we can create. We are creators. Bye, all of you. We'll take your
leave. Bye, ma'am. Thank you.
Best wishes. God bless you all.
Thank you. Wish you the same, ma'am. Thank you.